This is why you might not be able to get a wildlife job. Hey guys, today I'm going to talk about, are wildlife jobs competitive? I'm gonna go through some of the reasons why wildlife jobs are competitive, how you can improve your chances of getting a job, and the like honest answer of whether or not you'll actually be able to get a wildlife job. I just got back from Salt Spring Island, if you don't already follow me on Instagram, at @veganbelowzero. So things are messy and I'm not putting a lot of preparation into this video. I'm just gonna go for it and kind of talk honestly. So, yes. Okay, that's the end of the video. Just kidding. No, there's more to it than that. Yes, they are competitive, but obviously it's possible. I'm sitting here today with a wildlife job and I didn't get really good grades or go to graduate school or anything like that. Yes, it's competitive, but it's still possible if that's what your dream is. And there's also a few things you can do to increase your odds of getting a wildlife job. A lot of people have this idea that a wildlife job is working at a zoo and playing with chimpanzees and traveling the world.
G'day, I'm Steve Irwin.
And as much as I'd like you to believe that so that you could watch some of my other videos and subscribe to my channel, that's absolutely not the case, and it's not a glamorous, like, crazy job that's much better. Honestly, it's not even like that much better than some of the other science jobs. It's just a different type of specialty. But if you are passionate about animals and wildlife, you're gonna enjoy that much more than if you stuck yourself in a lab because you were too afraid to go towards a wildlife career. The main reason why wildlife biology is so competitive is because there's a lot of people who want to do it. There's a lot of schools that offer a wildlife degree, and you know, each of these schools is coming out with like dozens, if not hundreds, of graduates that are highly qualified, all wanting those wildlife jobs. And there's just not enough wildlife jobs to go around so that every student who graduates in wildlife can, you know, get an amazing job working with animals. We don't live in that kind of economy where there's enough jobs like that, especially as we're getting more and more job cuts in science and environmental sector. The levels are totally fluctuating of the amount of jobs that are available in wildlife. That's one of the main reasons why wildlife jobs are competitive. There's a lot of seasonal jobs or a lot of temporary jobs. When a permanent job opening pops up, it's gonna be even more competitive than anything else. So it can make it really, really difficult to get like a competitive government job or a permanent consulting job in wildlife. What I always say to people who want to increase their chances of getting a wildlife job is you have to diversify and you have to go a little bit more broad than just wildlife. You have to be open to environmental jobs that might put you in a position to take a wildlife job in the future. You have to be open to seasonal work. You have to be open to traveling. And if some of those things are deal breakers for you, like your lifestyle is not flexible enough, which fair enough, a lot of people are going back to school with kids, with families. But I recommend that if you're in one of those situations where you think your life is a little bit less flexible than it may need to be for wildlife, is that you go into more of a field like ecology or environmental science instead, where there's a lot more options. If you really do not have a flexible lifestyle where you can't kind of take the opportunities as they're given to you and you want to be a little bit more picky, go for the more general degree. And I know some of you who are watching this have wanted to be wildlife biologists from the age of 5 years old. Me and you and so boom, come along and see what's new. So this was not me. I did not want to be a wildlife biologist at a younger age. I only wanted to be a wildlife biologist when I was about 19 or 20. But if this is you, you are even in a better position to get a wildlife job because you have time or you have the passion and the dedication to get into this field. So a lot of people don't just end up in wildlife. You really need to be passionate and dedicated. It doesn't really fall in your lap. And you have to take some opportunities that might not be ideal in order to get yourself in the path to get a wildlife job. So if this is you, you're probably gonna enjoy all of the extra things I'm gonna talk about. So it's gonna be more like fun for you. But if you're not really passionate about getting a wildlife job, or you have some other reasons why you wanna go in wildlife outside of like a passion for saving and helping animals, you're probably not gonna find a lot of these things interesting or fun. And maybe that's a sign that this isn't the right field for you.
day after day, in the sun and the wind and the rain, I climbed into the hills. This was where I was meant to be.
So these are the things that are gonna give you a better chance at getting a wildlife job. So number one is volunteer work or internships. I know I've made a lot of videos about this. I'll link to one above in my internships video of how to get an internship, where I break it down a lot more than just in this video. You can't graduate with a degree in wildlife and get a good wildlife job right off the bat. It's almost never happens. Very, very rarely, like if you're parents are wildlife biologists and can get you like an in and a company maybe, but generally you have to have experience. Junior wildlife biologist jobs require around 3 years of experience. And so some people are like, how do I get the experience if the junior entry level position requires 3 years of experience? This answer to that is internships and volunteer work / summer student co-op positions, depending on what country you're located in. For example, volunteering at your local wildlife rehabilitation center. If you're someone like me, that sounds like a lot of fun and you wouldn't mind not getting paid for it. If you are lower income and you have to work for pay and you don't have any time to not work for pay, really focus on those paid internships. I got a paid internship paying $11.50 an hour in university for 2 years. Another thing that's gonna get you a wildlife job is determining if you need a graduate degree and going and getting that graduate degree. I talk a little bit more about graduate degrees and whether or not they're required in my graduate degree video I'll link to above. It depends on what kind of job you want to have of whether or not you're going to need a graduate degree. And some jobs specifically do require graduate degrees, such as being a professor in wildlife biology. So you're going to have to get that graduate degree before you get that job. Be less picky. So I get a lot of people who are sending me emails saying they specifically want to work at a zoo working with chimpanzees. I'm sorry if this sounds mean, but honestly, it's next to impossible to get a job that specific. You have to be more general. Maybe once you have 20 years of experience, you can go and get that specific job. Or maybe if you have a PhD, you are now closing yourself off to 99% of careers in what is already a competitive field. Don't close yourself off early. There's already so many limited jobs in wildlife. Don't start getting picky and getting all these specific things that you need to have, like, oh, I'm only gonna work with wolves. Just don't do that. Be open to everything. Be open to things outside of wildlife biology and just in the general ecology field. Take it, because you're now getting experience that's gonna be beneficial for wildlife jobs, and you're getting yourself in the door and you're meeting wildlife biologists and working with them. I only wanted to work with cougars when I graduated, and the one cougar biologist job I saw required a master's or PhD degree and like 10 years of experience. That's not gonna happen right off the bat. So when you see people on like Reddit and stuff saying the chances of getting a wildlife job is lower than winning the lottery, they're really talking about those types of jobs. And the reality is you have to think, how many jobs are there actually out there that need people who specialize in this one animal? It's very rare. A lot of times they want people who know all sorts of different animals. A lot of jobs don't want you to specifically only know one animal. Logically, like, you have to think about the economy behind it and whether or not people are actually gonna hire you to do this job and whether you're gonna be useful. So you have to think realistically of whether or not you can provide a service that people actually wanna pay for. Because as wildlife biologists, we are providing a service, whether that's research, whether that's experience, consultation, who's gonna actually pay for your skills? No one's just gonna hand you a job. Don't get your hopes up too high, too fast. You can have it all, just not all at once. It takes time and it takes patience and it takes a lot of hard work to get a wildlife job, and no one's gonna hand you anything when you graduate, but it is possible. Don't let this deter you from studying wildlife if your dream is to study wildlife. If you're not really sure and this seems honestly like too much work, maybe that's a sign that it's not the right career field for you. But if you watch this and you get excited about all the potential volunteer work, the internships, the animals you can work with, maybe it is a sign that it's the right career for you. So if you want to see more videos about being a wildlife biologist, click the subscribe button below, and thank you for watching.